HelloNina, I'm Reece from IBM Watson UK. I'm a sales specialist who focuses on Watson conversation. So we are here today in the IBM Design Studio. We're here looking at how our teams work using Watson to create ideas, apply design thinking methodologies, and help clients really build a cognitive system. In IBM, we work in a project team fashion. We support each other by working through the various different software approaches that we've got. We form Scrum teams, we work using Agile methodology, and we apply a lot of design thinking practice. So each team that you'll be able to see today, they work within a direct project. They're usually 6 months at a time. They work all together, pulling in all the various parts of IBM to incorporate the goal for the customer. The best advice that I can give to a startup to help them create the best bot for the future would be to really focus on delivering quality. So at the moment, there's a hell of a lot of bots out there. There's around 80,000 on Messenger, but some of them are not as good as others. I would really say focus on the personality and make something that's really useful. So the biggest challenge that I've come across with Watson so far is because it's just so big. It's a very big project to undertake for a business. So what we've done with IBM is we've broken this up into a lot of APIs. So we've split this Watson project into 26 APIs that a user is able to pull in and really pick up the parts of Watson that they want to build with. So almost like Lego building blocks, you're able to determine what you want to build with and how. So a good question that we often get is, how do bots fit into the future? Are they going to replace human jobs? I tend to take the approach that bots are really going to augment jobs, so they're going to help people do their job better. Ultimately, jobs that rely on information may find themselves shifting their approach in terms of what their role entails. So with a bot, the person that would usually feed that information to a user would probably be assisted by the bot, and their job would be to maintain that bot itself. So it's not necessarily a replacement, but it's more of a shift in job role and responsibility. At the moment, we're already seeing a shift in the market where there are jobs being advertised now for personality and conversational analysts. So at IBM, in our research labs in Hursley, we already employ two conversational analysts whose job it is to determine what language should be used in order to guide the customer through the bot in the right way, how the conversation should be structured in order to prompt the user, but also with our design teams here, how the user experience and customer interaction should be handled. So we're really looking at new job creation in terms of conversation analysts, user experience designers, and customer interaction analysts. The bot adoption, what we've seen at IBM, has been great. 2017 is definitely the year of the bot. A lot of organisations, industries and companies are adopting our technologies to make use of this conversational interface, this conversational approach to dealing with their customers. So as an insight for 2017, I'd probably say keep an eye on the big industries, so banking, retail, and see where bots might pop up in the future. So for HelloNina, Watson is a real great tool that allows you to go onto our developer cloud. We've got great starter kits that have already been pre-built by IBM that give you a lot of sample code on GitHub. They're publicly available. We've got great documentation that allows you to get started really quick. But the main thing is that our Watson services are all split out into 26 APIs. That means you're not paying for one big platform that you might not use part of. You pick and choose using our Lego building blocks APIs, the part that you wish to use that really allows you to be flexible in your approach to cognitive.